This video is brought to you by Skillshare. Hey guys, salut, this is Alex. So today I am up for a little challenge. Today I want to recreate, not only to recreate, but also to master, let's be honest, the world's best mashed potatoes. I'm basically gonna make mash. Buckle up, I'm gonna make mash. Buckle up, I'm gonna cook some tea. Buckle up, I'm gonna fry a basically mashed potatoes. Sounds like your average weeknight. And yet, it can be a 32 Michelin star dish. Let me show you. Say hi to my little friend, Joël Robuchon.
Bonjour. Oui, je vais vous faire mon cadeau de
Don't famille. Be fooled by this guy,
je
ok?
Je vais révéler le secret de la purée de pommes de terre. Première précaution d'importance, c'est de sélectionner des pommes de terre de même qualité.
Ok, potatoes.
En pot,
fine.
De les laver.
Pretty straightforward. This seems to be like russet, mice piper, just random mashed potatoes. Potatoes for mash. Cold water, as always. I don't think I need that. What's a mixer? I shouldn't be bitching about his French accent. Bad Alex. Just a touch of butter. And then a bit of milk to loosen the texture. Makes sense. I'm not even sure you need to pass it through a sieve. Then that's a dish, okay. I know I must be wrong at the moment, but to me it doesn't feel like rocket science. Joël Robuchon is one of the most talented chefs the planet has seen. You don't believe me? Fine, you think I'm biased. Great, Gordon Ramsay. Joël Robuchon is the godfather of Michelin. Marco Pierre White is a pussycat compared to Chef Robuchon. Eric Ripper. Joël was my mentor, the most rigorous, precise, demanding, ultra-gifted king of all chefs. Thomas Keller, one of the greatest influences for our generation, with a reach that cannot be easily measured. He influenced cooks like me to pursue their dreams. So I guess you get it, he's a big deal and his mash recipe is like world famous. Anyway, it's probably time for me to start cooking, okay? Ah, merde. So, to be really honest with you, I'm not starting from zero on this mashed potatoes recipe. For example, I know that I need to use a potato ricer instead of a food processor because you would end up with a gluey, stringy texture. The blades of the food processor are damaging the cells and these would leak out way too much starch. So, ricer. I added some room temperature butter, but I also added a bit of hot milk. Mashed potato is underrated. I would say it's a very good mom's mash. It's comfy, it's hearty, it's not silky, smooth. I don't think this was the texture that Joel had in his recipe. I think it was way looser. Yeah, it's moving in the plate. It's flattening, basically. And I'm just gonna amend the amount of butter, which I'm gonna amp up.
1,94 €.
I need to pass this through a sieve.
Damn it.
On Instagram, I noticed that Eric Ripper, Joël Robuchon's protégé, the Michelin star chef, is at the moment in Paris. So, hi, Eric. Would you like to share your opinion with me about purée de pommes de terre? Okay, back to work. It's beautiful. It's very delicate. So I've got a silver spoon with me. Let's go for it. Ooh. That's a whole experience on its own. It's smooth, rich, soft, but I'm not getting the same amount of pleasure that I usually get when I eat fluffy mash. I'm not getting a potato flavor. Is there something that I missed?
Bonjour.
Hmm?
Okay.
Did that? Okay, so I got something else, I think. When you peel potatoes beforehand, you allow water to leak in the potato. Second, when you're drying mash over low heat, get the moisture out in order to concentrate the flavors. Just want to share something fun. So these are fridge magnets. Each day, better than the last. Dad jokes. You can get these in my shop, but only for a limited period of time. It is very good. The question is, do I have a stronger potato flavor? Just the fact, to be honest, that I'm asking myself this question means that no, I don't think I have a stronger flavor. In fact, I've got the batch that I made earlier. This doesn't scream like potato, and this either. I'm fed up. I followed it to the letter. This is glossier than mine. I feel like I've seen this like 1,000 times. Exactly did that. Exactly what I did. For the first time on this channel, am I gonna give up? There must be something I missed in the first place.
Mashed potatoes are a must, especially when it comes to the holidays.
So... Eric Ripper did not answer. I'm losing it. Big time. So much mash. This one is just a video about Chef Robuchon chatting about his mighty purée.
La pomme purée qui avait été faite avec la rate est sortie première.
Okay, the very first thing I would have never questioned in this recipe is wrong. I'm laughing, but I'm mad. It's so stupid. Obviously. Let's just... Let's go back to basic with potato varieties. There are two big families of potatoes. You've got starchy, also called floury potatoes, russet, Maris Piper. When you cook them, they turn into mush. Every grocery store will recommend to make mash. These are the ones, obviously, that I used. The second big family is the waxy potatoes. They tend to stay together when you cook them. Red potatoes, Charlotte, the potato that Joel used. Stand right there. Rat potatoes. They are the most expensive, cherished potatoes in France. Only a fool would do that. Fool or genius, you decide, but unfortunately, Chef Joël Robuchon passed away last year. It was a great loss for the chef community, but probably for way more than just this community. Definitely a sad thing for me to know that I will never be able to meet the guy, but I feel like he already influenced me in many ways, including like this video for that matter. So, Chef, if you're watching me, I hope I'm making you proud, okay? I hope so. Let's get to it. Sponsor time. Skillshare is an online learning community with over 28,000 classes in design, business, productivity, creativity, and of course, cooking. I absolutely love learning new things. I love the challenge of discovering something new and trying to master it. Obviously. So at the moment, I'm following two classes. The first one is a crash course on beef cuts and how to prepare and to select them properly. It's a very important skill you need, especially when you have a coming series about meatballs. If you don't watch the ads, you can't know about my next series. And the second one is a logotype masterclass. I'm basically trying to design a beautiful logo for a project of mine. So Skillshare has a premium membership, which at less than 10 bucks a month is pretty affordable, especially if you consider everything that it offers. Unlimited access to all the classes, all the communities that are just right for you. If you want to give it a try, use the link in the description down below and get 2 months for free. Thank you, Skillshare, for sponsoring this video. Thank you. smooth, it's soft, it's more intense. I've got a toasted, nutty taste to it coming from the potato that I use, the rat. It's not like over the top yellow, but it's nice to have a bit of tint, a bit of hue, and not just something pale. I still get that chestnutty, buttery, potato-y, french fry-y aftertaste, I would say. These mashed potatoes are simply amazing. Taste so good in the end. What's the takeaway for you guys? What do you need absolutely to remember next time you do mashed potatoes at your place? First of all, you need to use a ricer. Stay away from a food processor, it's just gonna do wrong for mashed potatoes. Second, if you go for creamy mashed potatoes and not fluffy, you need to use a fine mesh sieve, otherwise you're gonna get lumps 100%. This is the absolute best mash I've ever tasted so far. Period. Forever. Eric Ripper. Unfortunately, he didn't got back to me. On this, I might need a little help from you guys. I would appreciate a lot if you guys were to send him a tweet, a kind and polite one. I will put all useful information in the description box down below. Plus, obviously, the details of the recipe we just made. I hope you enjoyed this. Bye-bye. Salut.